Hello everyone. In our previous session, we have discussed phase one of public relation process, that is scanning environment and identifying the PR problem. So in today's session, we are going to discuss phase second of public relation process, that is developing a communication plan. So in preliminary research, what we have conducted in the first phase of public relation process, that is identifying problem and scanning the environment, so which is considered as foundation for second phase of public relation process. So the preliminary research what is conducted for fact finding should construct a feasible objective here. So here public relation officer plans the communication strategy to overcome the problem. And what is important here is the planning must be related with the objective and available resources. So the objective may be to reinforce existing attitude. So if the first phase of public relation process find out that so the attitude of public attitude of publics towards organization is very feasible and very positive, then the immediate challenge of public relation officer is to reinforce existing attitude or retain the existing attitude. And the second objective may be changing attitude and behavior. In first phase, if at all they have found out that the public's attitude is changing towards negative approach, then their immediate problem is to solve the changing attitude. So the objective is to change the attitude from positive to negative. And the third one is to motivate certain action. So if you are launching certain product or if you are launching new idea, then the immediate problem of any public relation officer is to motivate customers to have certain action or stakeholders to have certain action. And the fourth objective may be facilitate internal working of organization and improve its efficiency. If management finds out that so the efficiency of the labor force is decreasing day by day, then the immediate problem to solve is to improve the efficiency of personnel of the organization. So the objective may be facilitating internal working of the organization very effectively and improve its efficiency. So but here the consideration of any program cannot divorced from the question of budget. So the budget allocation is done at management level. So it is the work of public relation officer to counsel and please the management to have enough resource for public relation activity. So normally what happens is many companies, they spend lot of amount for advertising and very less for public relation activity. So but public relation officer has to counsel the management about the importance of public relation of program. So he has to counsel the management to have enough money for public relation activity. And then the planning includes here the deciding the what kind of program they are going to implement, target group identification or orientation, media selection, message selection, creativity and innovation in program, and arranging manpower backup for the program, etc. So this comes under planning stage. So with regard to decision on PR program, so according to the intensity and mode of the public relation problem, so the program is decided. So they may decide to have a event or to celebrate anniversary or to have an open days wherein no target public can come and visit their organization, or they may arrange for exhibition, etc. So according to the intensity of the problem, so they can plan their program. And second one is target group orientation. The definition of target group to be reached out must be stated very clearly, and it must be based on demographic and psychographic features of their target audience. So they have to identify their role in organization. So if their target audience may be internal target group, that is employees of the organization, or they may be community members, or maybe bankers or raw material suppliers, etc. So target group orientation is very, very important because each target have their own demographic and psychographic feature. And then the next stage is media selection. The media to be used must be those which reach the right target group at right time at right price. So the right media have a significant role to play in publicity and public relations. So here they have to understand the media habit of their target audience. So for example, if they are targeting towards youth, they have to understand their media habit. Normally youth, they engage in new media. So then their target media is new media. It may be social networking site or maybe, you know, other new media materials like smartphones, etc. So they have to target towards new media here. Then the message selection. What kind of message I'm going to deliver? So it has to be directly linked and focused upon the objective to be achieved. And the message should be according to the demographic and psychographic features of the target audience. So the message may be to create awareness or to have an announcement on new idea or new product, or maybe shift in attitude from negative to positive, or to change in behavior, etc. So according to the objective of PR plan, your message can be selected here. And then the next step is to have creativity and innovation in your plan. So the more creative and innovative message will be, it will be noticed and better will be chance of achieving the goal. So creativity and innovation is considered as buzzword in public relation of activity, and it is one of the important quality of public relation officer. And the next is manpower backup and adequate resources. So to be effective public relation officer, he must be backed with adequate resources. And it is often recommended that if you do not have adequate resources and manpower backup, so then better not to, you know, undertake any public relation program, because you may have extensive public relation plan. So, but it may need, you know, it may invite the budget which is not in your hand. So make sure that you have adequate budget in your hand. So in conclusion, we can say that the planning public relation program or stage second of public relation program is considered as heart of public relation function. So if planning is done effectively, half of the problem is solved. So, but the public relation plan must be done in accordance with the objective and budgetary consideration of the activity. So, with this, I will conclude today's session. We'll meet again with the third phase of public relation process. So, thank you.